The University of Kentucky has two types of dorms for students to live in. There are older, traditional-style dorms, for example, Kerwin and Blaney Complex, and the newer suite-style dorms, for example, Champions Court. Incoming freshmen could have difficulties deciding where to live. The older dorms have benefits including close proximity to the Johnson Center, William T. Young Library, and Commons Dining Facility. The newer dorms are located near the Student Center and Whitehall Classroom Building.
What is in your heart? Weep, little lion man, you're not as brave as you were at the start. Rate yourself and rake yourself, take all the courage you have left and waste it on fixing all the problems that you made in your own head. But it was not your fault but mine, and it was your heart on the line. I really fucked it up this time, didn't I, my dear? Didn't I, my
dear? Welcome to Pillow 2. This is one of the older dorms on campus. It was built in 1967, which is quite clear from the outside architecture. The lobby, though petite, makes people more friendly and get to know you as you walk to and from classes. There are only three floors in the low-rises of the Kerwin Blanding Complex. None of the low-rises have an elevator, which isn't a big problem unless you encounter an injury. Many a time I have watched girls and guys struggle up the three flights of stairs on crutches or in a boot. Once on your floor, there are small hallways on each side that lead to two community bathrooms on each floor and two common areas with couches to hang out in. An individual room, you can... In an individual room, you can expect to find a quite cramped, dimly lit, shoebox-sized area. There is an open closet space next to a small vanity on top of a built-in dresser. Then there is a sort of an odd separation wall at the head of each bed, lined with what many describe as carpet. At the foot of the bed, there is a built-in desk and then a joint window area. Although the rooms are definitely not something to be desired, they force those living there to venture out into the floor's lobby and get to know each other and create a sense of family, as cheesy as that sounds.
Here outside Champions Court, one can tell there are not as many people around, taking away from the community aspect. There is a busier street nearby instead of a big courtyard like the one outside of the Blanding Kerwin complex. Champions Court. Built in 2014, these big brick buildings are 8 stories high with brand new furnishings and appliances. Walking into a typical room, one can find a kitchen area with sink and granite tops. His and her areas are located outside the individual bathroom. Inside the separate bedrooms, there are closets and Tempur-Pedic mattresses. There are elevators leading to every floor, so those with disabilities or injuries have no problems. The nice isolated rooms cause those who live in Champions Court to be less social, taking away the community aspect.
Thank you. I live in Champions Court.
And what is the best part about living there?
I would say the best part about living there would be the location. It's super close to all my classes in the student center, which is very convenient. Most of my classes are all in Whitehall since I'm a first year, so it's just really, you know, a 5-minute walk to all my classes. All the campus on food that takes plus and everything is right there and walking distance from my dorm also, which is really convenient. And I have study in the basement of my dorm, so whenever I have trouble with my homework, I can just walk down there.
Have you ever been to one of the older dorms like Blanding?
Yeah, actually my best friend lives in the towers right now, Blanding Towers. And there's definitely a big difference compared to my dorm.
What's the difference?
The thing that I like about the towers is everyone, there's so many people all together. But I definitely like how mine is secluded. I can get a lot more work done within my room than I know my friends do in the towers, just because it's kind of like one big sleepover in the towers. And like in my dorm, it's cleaner, it's nicer, newer. I can get a lot more work done.
So if you were going to suggest where somebody should live, would you suggest the new dorms where you live, Champions Court, or Blanding, like the towers?
I would definitely say the new dorm.
Hi, I'm Jill, and I live in Blanding 4. It's right by Commons, it's right by the JC, so it's pretty convenient for those things, but it's kind of far away from like Whitehall and the Student Center, so that's kind of the downside.
What is your favorite part about living in the older dorms?
I really like that there's a sense of community because it's so easy to meet people in these dorms. Like, everybody's just always out and about, and I met some really, really close friends here. So I think that's one of, like, the biggest things about living in the old dorms.
If you were to suggest to an incoming freshman whether they should live in an old dorm or a new dorm, what pros and cons would you give them for both?
For living in a new dorm, it'd be nice because, they're obviously new and they're closer to things.
While the newer dorms are better furnished, they come at a cost of about $1,300 more per year than the older dorms.
Hi, my name's Ellen, and I live in Kerwin 2, which is one of the traditional dorms. And next year, I'm actually living in Hagen, which is one of the newer dorms. And I would definitely recommend for freshmen to live on South Campus because you meet a lot of people and it's a great sense of community. And for upperclassmen to live in one of the newer dorms, just because you get more space and privacy for yourself.
As a solution to the vast differences between the Blanding and Kerwin complex and the Champions Court dorms, we would like to suggest that some of the newer dorms being built or new dorms in the future should be built with similar exteriors to the new, more luxurious dorms. Once inside, though, they will still have the traditional community aspects. Ideally, they would be located more centrally or in the place of the old South Campus dorms that are there now. In these locations, they would offer close proximity to many food places as well as the gym and the library. Having an offer of a new, more livable community-style dorm would create more desire for the incoming students that want to live together and create better freshman community. This solution would create more friendships and therefore more comfortable students who can then focus and do well in both academic and social realms.